Away first time, and Hession smoothly out of the blocks. Dick's making up some ground in the low.
Beijing went really well. It was probably the pinnacle of my career. But like a lot of things in my career, I was so close to doing really well and being part of history. And I was very close, but at least I was close, you know, and I gave it a good go.
Terrific run by Paul Hession to finish in fifth place, but sadly not to qualify for the final of the 200 metres, but a dramatic performance.
That semi-final in Beijing, I suppose, I do look back on it and think what could have happened, you know. If I had made that final was shown across the world to millions of people and still is shown all the time as the world record run by Bolt when he broke. You know, the Michael Johnson's world record. I could have been part of that, and it was, you know, a meter away, you know, or less from making it. I went to college to be a doctor, really, not to be a runner. When I went there, I was thinking I was going to be a good athlete. I was going to be an asset to the college, and I did manage to get a sports scholarship from them, which was great. But I didn't really see myself as an Olympian, you know. I thought it was more of a dream than a possibility or probability. By the time I had done my first 3 years in NUI Galway, I had come a long way. You know, I brought structure into my training. I was able to do it as a student, but I was coming to the point where I recognised that I had to move on. You know, I had to train full time if I really wanted to get the best out of myself, and that's what I did. As a kid, the Olympics is everything, you know. The Olympics is what you watch on the telly. And for me, having ran in two and almost ran in a third, I suppose now I can look back and realise that it was a good achievement, especially as a sprinter, you know, there wasn't too many of us. So to do it from the west of Ireland as well was I recognise, a great achievement, you know, and I do look back over it with pride. Gaining respect wasn't easy along the way. But I think I got there, you know. I was very consistent and I ran really well, and it wasn't just in the Olympics and World Championships. I used to run very well in the European circuit day to day, and I actually the hard way earned the respect, I think, of the Americans and the Jamaicans and other sprinters that I was starting to beat, you know, even the odd time, which was great.
And it's his season's best.
So I still hold the Irish 200 metre record. I set it in Santry at the National Championships, actually, back in 2007, I think. I was the pinnacle of my best times, and I just ran really well. I won the race by 15 metres or something. And that's the record that still stands. It's amazing. At the time, I thought it was just a stepping stone to something more and more and more. You never know when you've reached your best time, and it just happened to be that day.
Your leading time for Paul.
After London, I went back to medicine. When I went back to college, it was a difficult transition. I'd been out for 6 years, but I got through it. And I qualified in 2014 and began my internship in Tala. I'm doing anaesthetics now. It's a very good scheme. It's very well organized. It's going to be tough, but there's a lot of things from my running that I think I can bring to it. So I think the running will help my career, and I certainly don't regret all the years I put into it. I look back with pride over it, and I think I can use it going forward to make anaesthetics work for me.